Day one, let's go.
And has amnesia and can't remember anything, so you have to tell her how much. Wait, remind her first.
She has amnesia? Pick who has amnesia, pick who's the other sister, and I just want to see a nice, like, you can either go touching, you can, like, try to be deceitful, like, any way that you want to play your scene out.
Hey, how are you doing?
Whoa, whoa, whoa! Back up, who are you?
I'm your sister.
Yeah, right. My family?
You don't remember? You don't remember, do you?
Remember what?
Oh, you do everything for me. My homework, you do all the chores in the house. You're like the best sister ever.
I do sound like a pretty good sister.
Exactly. You love it too. It's like your favorite thing. Yeah.
Alright. As soon as we make it home, I'll clean your room.
Good. Perfect.
Yep. I'll dust.
Well, the unicorns broke out of the cage again. They're in the cotton candy machine.
I think I saw some people doing that.
Well, that's a real big health code violation. Don't you think?
We can just cover that up.
Well, you covered up the cracks in the glass from there.
They were fighting over the waterproofing. They're doing it again.
Oh,
shit. Yeah, yeah. Now you've got it. Is Chilbury dead? I want John Cusack holding a boombox outside my window. I want Jake from 16 Candles waiting outside the church for me. And I want Judd Nelson walking across the school parking lot, thrusting his hands in there because he knows he's got me.
And just once, I want my life to be like a John Cusack movie. Sure, everything starts out a mess, but it always ends up great and hopeful and awesome, big scene where the main character puts on a huge display.
From the whole school and wins the day. But no, John Hughes didn't drug my life.
Maybe chivalry isn't dead.
I had that idea when I was filming everything, and I thought it'd be really cool, and it looked really cool, so yay!
Out of nowhere, cheese it first.
So that was a successful day one. Wasn't able to film because the things. Everyone laughed like crazy. That was annoying. Day two. What's up? We here. We out here. Set build. Let's go. Alright.
There's tons and tons of corn!
There's corn?
Corn!
Corn!
I mean, I wouldn't put it past you if you thought that was corn.
It looks like corn.
Hot corn!
It's Del Monte! Del Monte makes corn. Yo, what's up, guys? Welcome back to Paranormal Investigator. It's the ghost! There's chairs over here, but I'm not certain that they're the chairs that we need.
There's a chair over there, but I'm not sure.
Law and Order Special Victims Unit.
I found a desk. There's two chairs over there, but they have, like, things on the bottom of them.
Wait, what? Like, oh, yeah, you're right. Oh, no. No,
it hit button!
Oh, ground.
Ground!
Let's go to the second foot now.
Round, round,
rah, rah, rah. Rah, rah,
rah, Unis, 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 Unis.
We did nothing, I promise.
Pleads not guilty to all counts.
Oh, come off it, Peep. No jury out there would swallow that, even if it was corn battered and served on a stick.
Why, his middle names are Big and Bad.
That's not my name.
Yeah.
No, it's okay. I want to talk. I gotta get this off my chest.
Yeah, I still want the, my name. I want those spotlights all the way up to the teaser bases.
Oh yeah, absolutely out of nowhere. We just had to use the gym, so that happened.
You look nothing like you on TV.
Neither do you, space kid.
I'm a cop. I'm not an actor anymore. I'm a cop. For now, I have to decide.
2 days until the show and no one is backstage. Oh boy.
Is this gonna be a fun 2 days? Probably a lot of footage, maybe. Who knows? Probably not. Let's start the quote-unquote montage.
Today, I drew a mirror of the things I like to love.
So we just finished previews for the high school, and now we're about to do elementary. So you're not in the hey.
Is this for your
behind the scenes?
Behind the scenes.
Yep. I love editing. Ooh. But we just finished. I'll come back in a sec.
So look what I found. Yay!
Day one of the shows. Let's go. We out here, show number one, let's go. I got a broken arm, don't ask.
Fall. No, it wasn't. It's not easy to describe the kind of fall it was, but if I had to describe it, I'd say it was great. It was a great fall. It was great. I regained consciousness in a gurney over at Kings County. They did everything they could to fix my bone fractures, my torn joints, my broken soul. All the finest doctors lent a hand. Human doctors, of course, but also horse doctors. After surgery, the chief resident put his hook in my hand, and he told me everything was gonna be all right. But he was all wrong! No matter how hard they tried, they failed! They failed at putting me back together again! You wanna know about my physical stability? I'll be all right. Sure, I'll survive. But after a fall of such great magnitude, I may never recover. Up here, and in here, and along here. For those of you out there, listen to me and listen close. Because I'm only going to say it once. When you see a wall, respect that wall. Sit down. Sit on a chair. Or maybe a futon. Now, I quit!
And that ends the conclusion of the drama club behind the scenes. Let's end it with a song. The way you walk, the way you talk makes me wanna leave you. Hey, as I sing in the background, I'm gonna get a little serious for a sec and talk about the production of the show and stuff that I didn't get on video and stuff. So, first of all, let me start with, holy crap, this cast and crew is amazing. Like, legitimately, I cannot believe that I get to work with these people beside me, even though I only do a small portion of the entire show. I only do the acting portion, and I help somewhat develop other people's characters, but I mostly just work on my own characters, because obviously that's what I'm supposed to do. But I only contribute small portions, but everyone together makes up a giant and great portion of it, and everyone did amazing. I literally have no words. Everyone is amazing in this production. Shalou, Mama Reese, everybody. The actors, the stage crew, people who aren't even seen during the show who did tiny little parts of it, people who weren't even there, who, you know, were in spirit. I mean, does it really count? I don't know, but we'll count it anyway. It's just amazing the kind of work and talent that these people put into the production that you don't normally see. And this is kind of what I strive to do with this. I mean, I was more trying to get some footage and show what it was like to be in drama club and see how the rehearsals went and stuff. The set build was really short, so I couldn't really do much. And I was really just expecting this video to not even come out, because I was like, oh, we're not going to have enough footage to make this into just a subsequent thing. There's not enough time. It's just going to be the shortest minuscule little video, so I'm just going to combine it with the Mamma Mia behind the scenes. But you're going to see that in a couple of months, so I hope you enjoy that one. If you are watching this in the future, it's out, and you can go watch it. So, yeah. Thank you to everyone who worked on this production. Thank you for watching this video, which is just crazy. So, thank you so much. Thank you to everyone who contributed, and thank you for watching. You guys are amazing, every single one of you. Thank you for watching, and I will see you in a couple of months, aka like in like a minute's time. So thank you. Thank you.